Hi everyone, welcome to Presenting. My name is Kane, this is Emily, and today we're so excited to be joined by Man United and England footballer, designer, and occasional beatboxer, Jesse Lingard.
Hey Jesse, thanks for joining us today.
No worries, thank you very much. Thank you for having me on the show.
It's a pleasure to have you, man. How are you feeling?
Nah, I'm feeling good, feeling confident. I'm always good, I'm always happy, positive, you know.
That's yeah. That's what you're about to hear. This is Real Talk, where we go deeper into the issues that really matter. Jesse, thank you so much for coming on today to speak about your mental health and supporting someone with a mental illness.
No worries, I'm ready.
You've spoken before about supporting your mum in times where she's really struggled with her mental health. Just how difficult is it to see a parent go through something as hard as depression?
Yeah, it's hard. Even when I was younger, she was going through it. And, you know, it's hard for her. You know, when you're younger and you're seeing your mum going through that, you don't understand it, you know, logically, really. You don't know what she's going through. And, you know, sure, she's saying, I'm depressed. But for me as a kid, you don't know what that means, you know what I mean? You know, you're just going out, playing football, doing your thing. But why, you know, my mum was in bed most of the time, you know, curtains closed, and, you know, she's going through it. And this is when I was young, like 12.
Wow.
You know, like I say, we had the help for her. And even for me, it's hard just to bottle things up, you know what I mean? It feels like, you know, you're not the same person. Like, I feel like I weren't Jesse Lingard. Like, even when I was playing football matches, I felt like the game was just passing me by. Like, I just didn't want to be there. It was crazy. Like, I could see myself playing, but like watching the game, and I'm thinking, that's not me. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's not how I play. You know what I mean? Like, you go from the World Cup to some performances that I've been playing. I'm like, nah. I said, something needed to change. So obviously, I opened up to, you know, to Man United, told them what I was going through, told them what my mum was going through. And, you know, there's always there to help. You know, I've had, you know, other doctors that have helped as well, which have been brilliant. And, you know, during the lockdown, you know, I got my head together, you know, because I could have easily quit in lockdown. I could have been like, nah, I don't want to do it. I quit, I give up, whatever. But, you know, the fight in me, you know, always bring me back to life. And, you know, I feel like exercise is important. You know, I've told my mum that, to go for walks. And, you know, she has been doing that as well, which has helped. So I feel like lockdown has transitioned me, you know, in a way. You know, I watch my old games back. Just to watch like the World Cup games even and the old games I used to play and used to think like, yeah, that's the real Jesse Lingard, you know what I'm saying? And the time that I had going, obviously, I think a couple of seasons back or last season, just wasn't me at all. And you can see that, it's crazy. Like my brother who lives with me could see it. Like I think he's got a video of me where I'm just laying on the couch and I'm literally just staring for 3 minutes into thin air. And he's thinking like, what is he going through? He's got the whole like weight on his shoulders and everything. When I finally opened up and everyone understood, he's like, oh, well, that's why. And then it was just after that, just getting my head back together, concentrating on football, helping my mum. So, you know, I didn't really have time for anything else, really.
I feel like lockdown for some people has been quite hard, but also for some others, it's like the world has kind of slowed down. Would you say before, when there was so much pressure, there was actually a point where you were going to hang up your boots and quit football?
Not quit football. Just have a time out, really. Like I was going like into games like happy sitting on the bench, and like I think that's not me. Mine wasn't there. Like I wasn't focused at all. I was thinking about other things. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And obviously bottling up, sitting there like trying to play football, you tense, you stress, and everything. You can't do it. So like I say, you finally open up. Like you said, lockdown can be difficult for many other people as well. And I feel like it is important to, you know, to speak out and get the issues sorted. You know, dread to think what other people are going through. You know, for us, you know, we can get out of the house and go training, you know, and come home. But I feel like it's important to exercise. Like I was in the last lockdown, in the last March, I was pretty much running every day outside, trying to get fresh air. And it helps because, you know, sitting in the house all day, you know, when it's dark and it's depressing, it's really depressing. So just to get exercise, get out, get some fresh air and open up.
And back to kind of when you did open up, was there like a specific moment that made you think like, I need to speak out about this?
Yeah, I think it was just the things what was going on with mum, you know, behind the scenes and even me. So a lot of things happened, you know, with mum where we couldn't get it sorted. And you know, obviously I spoke to the manager and the club doctor at the club, and, you know, they helped out massively. And like I say, the team that I've got around me. You know, I spoke to one doctor to get us started, and after opening up and sharing my thoughts, it made it easier for me. It was weight off my shoulders. I could play football, I could concentrate and try and get back to the Jesse Lingard that everyone knows. So I feel like in life you go through difficulties, you go through stages of you know, the lows and the highs, but I feel like, you know, you've got to get through the lows, grind it out, and you see the light at the end of the tunnel. You know, because I'm still young, so I've got, you know, plenty of years ahead of me. And you know, I tell my mum, like, don't worry, like, we're in a good position. You know, I've always got your back, I'll always support you, and she's the same with me. So, you know, it'll be like that till they are there.
Have the struggles your mum faced and the way you've opened up about them changed the way you speak to your siblings about mental health?
Yeah, like I said, it's different back then, because, like I said, when my mum was depressed and, you know, she was in bed, I've only known that, do you know what I'm saying? I only known her being like that. But I think as the generation has changed now and a lot more people are speaking out, you know, I feel like it can progress and be better. I think a lot of people will start opening up now. I've got siblings and, you know, even my brother, you know, he goes through that sometimes. He goes through stages of depression, and, you know, it's hard for the younger generation, but like I say, it's good to speak out, open up, and share your experiences as well. I think that's the most important thing.
And what is something that you have learned through supporting someone with depression?
When you open up, and I feel like you feel like you're a butterfly, you're in a cocoon, you just open up, you can spread your wings, you can fly. It's an amazing feeling, and, you know, now I've got all that behind me, I can literally just concentrate on football and my family, and that's all I wanted to do. But of course, like I say, you're going to get, you know, dragged through the highs and lows, and, you know, when you're at a low point, you've got to find that something in you, that never give up attitude, just to go again, because I've never been a quitter, you know what I'm saying? So for me, it was like, it was mad, because a lot, it's going to sound strange, but the lockdown came at the right time for me. It was really like, sit back, think, and be like, what am I actually doing? Like, I need to get back to how I was. Like, it's mad, it made me just like sit back and think, let me just watch some old clips, some old videos, and get back to how I was. And I got told off a doctor ages ago, as soon as you wake up, you know, open your curtains just to get the light in. There's some days where I used to, like, we used to have a game at 8 o'clock, and then we go to the hotel in the afternoon, and then I go sleep from like 2 till 4, like, shut my curtains, dark, and then wake up and it'll be dark. Do you know what I'm saying? You haven't seen any sunlight. So I always got advised by the doctor, just as soon as you get up in the morning, you know, jump out of bed, open the curtains, and even just them little things can just change, like, your attitude a bit. It's mad, like, sitting in a dark room, you're going to be depressed. If there's light in the room and, you know, you get up, you open the curtains, you know, you get up straight away, have a coffee, get up, get dressed, you'd be a total different person for the day, I believe so.
Yeah, that's so true. Just kind of like putting one foot in front of the other, like the next thing, open the curtains, you know, get dressed. I think taking it step by step is a really good piece of advice.
Start the day positive and on the right foot.
Jesse, thank you so much for being so open and honest with us today. I'm sure this conversation is going to help a lot of young people.
Yeah, I think that's the main aim. That's why I did open up. I want to obviously change people's lives and inspire others to start opening up. Because, you know, I've been through it and I know what it's like to bottle things up. And if I can pass on the information to anyone who's going through mental health issues, you know, it'll make me smile.
Jesse, this is Tell Me When. We're going to ask you a couple questions about your younger years, and all you have to do is share the first thing that comes to your mind. First time you felt growing up?
Now.
Now?
Really?
Nah. See, me as a child, yeah, I always, like, had things given to me. Like, my nan and granddad and my mum were always, like, you know, they make me breakfast. I weren't, like, independent at all. And then I think it come to the time where I moved out. I had to move schools, and then I went to a school in Sale called Ashland and Mersey, and we stayed with another family at the time in Diggs. So, you know, that responsibility there was big. And then even after that, even going on loan, you know, you're on your own, you have to, you know, fend for yourself, you have to do everything yourself, so become more independent. And then, you know, as soon as I had my daughter Hope, you know, my life just changed. And then, you know, you grow up after that, and, you know, I've got a dog as well, which is 10 times worse than a baby, oh my God.
Yeah.
He keeps me on my toes. Through the years, you know, you live and you learn, and, you know, you eventually, you know, mature and grow up. And you know, even though I'm growing up and mature, I still have, you know, a banter with my boys and always have a laugh, and that's my personality. I'm always bubbly and what I make people smile, you know what I mean? So.
When was the first goal you scored?
Our first goal?
Just the one that's significant that you can remember, the first time you felt like, wow, I'm really doing this.
Obviously the first goal for England and United, and then at a season, 17-18 season, where I scored a lot of goals and went to the World Cup, scored in the World Cup. The goals that I scored are all special, to be honest. Even from like when I was young and, you know, our team won the Youth Cup and I scored in the final a lot. So yeah, I'd say most of them are pretty special, to be fair.
The World Cup one must have been like super sweet though. Because that summer was like ridiculous. Everyone in the pubs, following the football.
Yeah, we seen obviously the videos back home, because we was kind of isolated really. We didn't see what was going on back home. But you know, when you started winning 2 and 3 games, it's like, right, they can actually go on and win it. So
yeah.
Down to like the Colombia game and like the scenes after that, when we won that, we watched the videos from back home. It was amazing, and you know, we did the country proud.
Who was your first best friend?
I'd probably say Lionel Cole. I've been with Lani since under sevens at United, and then we came through the ranks. He got released, went to Fulham. And then like during that period, it was weird because, you know, we both transitioned and he went one way and I stayed at United. So, you know, we kept contact, but we weren't like regular like we used to. And then during lockdown, you know, we came and stayed at mine. So we bonded again, we was training, we was working hard, and I felt like lockdown, you know, kind of brought us together and closer. And now I still speak to him regularly, you know, every day as well. So, you know, I've known him since I was seven. We stayed in his, digs in his auntie's as well. No, it's an amazing experience, like the journey you can go on with the same people, even the whole team that we had growing up. We came through the ranks together.
And that was Tell Me When. Jesse, thank you for sharing some of those early memories with us.
Appreciate it.
Hi guys, here at Presenting, we're all about breaking down barriers and social taboos, which is why we're proud to be supported by Manscaped for today's episode. Manscaped are the best in men's below-the-waist grooming, offering precision-engineered tools to make sure you don't have any accidents when you trim. Manscaped launched in the UK last year and is probably the best thing to come out of 2020 apart from Presenting. If you're listening to me speak right now, I want you or any men in your life to just experience it firsthand for yourself. There's a reason why Manscaped is trusted by over 2 million men worldwide. To get 20% off and free delivery, use the code PRESENTING at manscaped.com. That is 20% off and free delivery when you use the code PRESENTING at manscaped.com. Bow, nice cardboard. My balls will thank me. Oh, nice little boxes. I think this is the one. Ooh. Is it? Ooh. Now, back to the episode.
This is Rate the Fit. We're going to show you some pictures of you and your friends, and all you have to do is talk us through the first thoughts that come to mind.
Fresh.
Fresh. Yeah.
How much would you give it out of 10?
Probably doing a photo shoot for someone, so I'd say strong 8 out of 10.
Could you rock the boots at all?
You could, but I wouldn't wear them personally. But a person like him, I think he can pull off anything, I think. Ali Khalid.
Yeah.
You know what? He's fresh, yeah? All grey. I never go all grey.
So what do you mix the colours with?
Nah, I mean all grey. I've got all grey on now. But I'd wear like a white crepe. I'm going to say 6.
But 10 out of 10 for the dog.
Yeah, 10 out of 10 for the dog, yeah. What makes his coat? I'll give that a 7, actually.
Okay.
Like I said, no one. He just about saved himself.
Whoa. Nah, he looks great. I think that's a holiday vibe, innit? Hat back, shades on.
It has to be.
But the, is it a cut off shirt there?
Yeah. Cut off flannel.
What would you call that?
A flannel, like a lumberjack
shirt? What are they?
Yeah, you can pull it off on holiday.
Yeah, 100.
I give him a strong 8 there until.
All right, next we've got Marcus Rashford.
Rashy. This is for his Burberry campaign. Still fresh.
But it's a bit like scarf
and shorts. So wouldn't even flex on the beach, you know, just standing in one corner, just Burberry down.
You got a scarf on the beach. You can't have a scarf on the beach, bro. But Burberry's fresh anyway. And obviously he's got the scarf to match the shorts. I say strong seven.
So the next one is Dele Alli.
He's got the Vans, he's got the rude socks. I just wish his hat was the same colour as his
pants. Yeah, I was thinking that as well.
I think it's fresh. And then if you had a green beanie to match the green cargo pants, then that'd be fresher.
So, you're very hell-bent on like colour coordination.
Yeah, I like colour coordination. You know, maybe Dele doesn't, but I think on this, I'll go for a seven.
And last, you should see.
You've got Jesse.
10 out of 10.
10 out of 10. No debate. Double denim.
Yeah, that was with a GQ magazine before the World Cup. Made me wear all LV.
Wow.
But I don't think I'd wear that daily.
What kind of occasion would that be?
I don't know. Like, sometimes double denim's like...
Yeah.
I think the white shoes kind of make the outfit. If you have black shoes, it won't work. But obviously, they had stylists there in it, so... I'll give it a strong 10, thanks.
I think the person that won this was Jesse
Lingard. And that brings us to the end of today's episode. Jesse, it's been so lovely to meet you. Thank you for joining the conversation with us here at Presenting.
No, I appreciate that. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
To everyone watching, we hope you enjoyed this as much as we did.
And if you'd like to see more of Jesse, his socials will be linked in the description below. And for more episodes like this, be sure to like, subscribe, and hit the post notification bell so you never miss an episode. Thank you. I'm not even gonna lie, I related to like the whole thing.
Yeah.
I think just even when he's talking about the cut, example, like with depression and just like sleep is one thing you think.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be like, when I was a young person, like, why are you sleeping all the time? Mm. Like, what's going on? But I don't know. I think it's quite.
Did you know though? Like
I wouldn't know. You can't associate.
You don't
at
know.
At the end of the day, you feel like this is what you grow up with. Okay, cool. My mum is like this as a person.
Mm-hmm.
It's not okay. I haven't seen her in a period of time where, okay, she's not stressed. So therefore, something must be up. This is the kind of attention. This is the kind of stuff that's going on. So I feel like for me and my sister, we're just kind of like confused.